My mom did not sleep. She felt exhausted. She was irritable, grumpy, and bitter. She was always sick until one day, suddenly she changed. One day, my dad said to her, I've been looking for a job for 3 months and I haven't found anything. I'm going to have a few beers with friends. My mom replied, It's okay. My brother said to her, Mom, I'm doing poorly in all subjects at the university. My mom replied, Okay, you will recover. And if you don't, well, you repeat the semester, but you pay the tuition fees. My sister said to her, Mom, I smashed the car. Mom replied, Okay, daughter, take it to the car shop and find how to pay, and while they fix it, get around by bus or subway. Her daughter-in-law said to her, Mother-in-law, I came to spend a few months with you. Mom replied, Okay, settle in the living room, couch, and look for some blankets in the closet. All of us gathered, worried to see these reactions coming from Mom. We suspected that she had gone to the doctor and that she was prescribed some pills called I Don't Give a Damn. Perhaps she was overdosing on these. We then proposed to do an intervention. My mother, to remove her from any possible addiction she had towards some anti-tantrum medication. But then she gathered us around her and explained. It took me a long time to realize that each person is responsible for their life. It took me years to discover that my anguish, anxiety, my depression, my courage, my insomnia, and my stress does not solve your problems, but instead aggravates mine. I'm not responsible for the actions of anyone, and it's not my job to provide happiness, but I'm responsible for the reactions I express to that. Therefore, I came to the conclusion that my duty to myself is to remain calm and let each one of you solve what corresponds to you. I've taken courses in yoga, meditation, miracles, human development, mental hygiene, vibration and neuro-linguistic programming. I found a common denominator in them all. I can only control myself. You have all the necessary resources to solve your own problems, despite how hard they may be. My job is to pray for you, love and encourage you, but it's up to you to solve them and find your happiness. I can only give you my advice if you ask me, and it depends on you to follow it or not. There are consequences, good or bad, to your decisions, and you have to live them. So from now on, I cease to be the receptacle of your responsibilities by default, the sack of your guilt, the laundress of your remorse, the advocate of your faults, the wall of your lamentations, the depository of your duties. Who should solve your problems or spare a tire every time to fulfill your responsibilities? From now on, I declare all of you to be independent and self-sufficient adults. Everyone at my mom's house was speechless. From that day on, the family began to function better because everyone in the house knew exactly what it is that they needed to do. For some of us, this is hard because we have grown up being the caregivers, feeling responsible for others. As mom and wives, we are fixers of all things. We never want our loved ones to go through difficult things or to struggle. We want everyone to be happy. But the sooner we take that responsibility off our shoulders and on to each loved one, the better we are preparing them to be me's responsible rather than responsible. We are not here on earth to be everything to everyone. Stop putting that pressure on yourself. I did my bit. You too, do it. Thank you.